Welcome to the PlayStation Summer Sale Part 3. Here we go. We got everyone's favorite anime game, Jump Force. It's a fighting game that has a difficulty of a 5 out of 10 and 70 hours. And a couple online trophies, but maybe if you get Challenger out the way, you'll be fine with that. And then there's two winning trophies with rank and players, so that should be fine. And everything else about the game, screw Dio. And I'm only saying that because every time I play online, someone has to pick him and abuse him. Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 3, Battle for Neighborville is a 4v4 multiplayer shooter with a variety of weird character classes available, and you're playing as zombies or the plants. So difficulty is probably like a 3 out of 10 and maybe, just maybe 150 hours. I mean, it looks like it's a hell of a grind of a game. For those who hasn't platinumed the game on the PS3 can finally redeem themselves on the PS4. With a 3-hour difficulty and 15 hours, you'll finally get that platinum in no time without all the multiplayer grind you have to deal with. And please, do not get the 2016 Ghostbusters game. Just please don't get that. This game is definitely worth it. Call of Call of Scary Duty is a story-driven game that's from a short story of the same name in a 1981 RPG of the same name, which I never really looked at or heard of. But okay, so it's a 2 out of 10 in 15 hours of time, I guess. So yeah, I'm getting it. So this is very confusing. I think Hitman 2, well first of all, Hitman 2 is a stealth game, and it has 4 out of 10 with maybe 100 hours of completing the whole thing. But for some reason, this has something to do with the first one, and it has all this downloading stuff, this PlayStation Plus. I don't know what the whole detail about it is, but it has something to do with Hitman 1. So if you don't have Hitman 1, you can't really play this Hitman 2, maybe? I don't know, but I'm buying them anyway, so maybe I shouldn't be purchasing them. I have no clue, but yeah, I'm getting this and the expansion pass. So yeah. Star Ocean First Departure R is a remake of the 2008 PSP version and the original RPG from the Super Nintendo. So yeah, it has maybe a 4 out of 10 and possibly 50 hours to complete. So yeah, it's one of those RPG games that I probably really want to play so bad until I start playing The Last Hope, which is a different story. But yeah, MX Nitro Unleashed is a racing game, and yeah, there's not much information about it. I just know I'm pretty sure it has online trophies, and it's made by Saber Interactive, and anything from Saber Interactive, it's very, very bad. So yeah, just let you know, I might get this. It's $5, why not? And yeah, moving forward. Valetherian Ace, I don't know how to say that, but Hero School Story, it's an RPG game mixed with simulation, and it's kind of a 3 out of 10 in 20 hours to platinum, plus it's hella stackable with three other regions. So I guess, yeah, it's $5, so I guess why not just get the game. Nippon Marathon, it's a multiplayer racing game with 4 people locally. Does it even have online? I don't think so, maybe. I have no clue, but yeah, it's 3 out of 10 and 10 hours to complete, possibly. So yeah, I'm not sure, but I know this is stackable with the Japanese one, and actually the Japanese was actually free last month. Damn, I missed that opportunity. And that's 9 games for this week. Let me know in the comment section which game to play, and I'll see you on part 4.